Good morning, everybody, and welcome to the Harry Lonely Bayshore Community Center here for game one of the semifinal match today. We've got the Broomshack Becancour against the Maritime Lobster Fisherman, and this is a mixed semifinal game today, so it's looking like it's going to be a fantastic get-go. Even looking at some of how these two teams got here, it was both teams played fantastic to be able to get to this point. And we're just going to take a look at the standings. We've got Mislead obviously in first, but Becancour had a good run. 3-1 they ended up. Maritime is right behind them, 2-2, and they both played some pretty fantastic games the last two games, so hopefully one of them is going to generate here and have a good game, and hopefully it's good for both teams, but only one obviously can come out on top. So we're gonna throw it down to the floor, and the teams are huddling here right now as we speak. Getting ready for face-off here. And if you're not overly familiar with the entire, if this is your first game watching Broomball here, we've got two 18-minute periods with a 2-minute halftime in between. So the two teams are gathering here, and we hope to be going underway and face off in just moments. They're at the face-off. In good generation, first of all, here. I'm here with my color guy, Ryan. How are you?
Oh, not too bad. Been a busy morning.
I can imagine. So, give me a little bit of a rundown of what you feel has been between these two teams, their play so far in this tournament.
Broomshack was in the semifinal in the Page playoff against Mislead yesterday, and they actually jumped out to an early 2-0 lead, and everyone in the rink probably thought they were gonna win that game, but Mislead came back from behind and beat them 3-2. So Broomshack, they're kind of reeling from that because they haven't lost a game in a couple years. The Lobster Fishermen, they beat our host team yesterday in a close game. They got maybe a couple easier goals than they're going to get today. So they're excited, though. It's the first time they've been at Nationals in 4 or 5 years, and they are so excited to be here and playing with a chance at a gold medal.
So Maritime currently has the ball, and they dish it out to center. Pass it across, and number four, Francois Borges, is in the corner battling for it. And the puck goes, and the ball goes back out. Back to center. Maritime takes a shot and just misses wide there.
One thing's for sure, we're not going to get any words of advice from the players on the ice. The Maritime team is predominantly French, and the Quebec team is French. I don't speak French. I'm pretty sure you don't speak French.
I don't speak any French, no.
So we're not going to understand anything they say to each other on the ice.
Back at center, Maritime dishes it up. Broomshack now has the ball and trying to generate some offense there in the middle. Junior Duggan passes it out front, and that's intercepted in the middle. Number 17, Danny Levine, brings it back out. But then it comes back out to center. Number 92, Oliver Racin, has it. And he's looking for an opening, passes it over to his teammate in the corner. That's Frederick Lauren. Lauren has it, passes it forward. There's Oliver again, battling forward in the corner. Maritime has it. That's number one, Junior Duggan again. He passes it way out down the other end. And the goalie will pass it back. You know, Ryan, this is my first time commentating Broomball, and the one thing I'm already impressed about is the speed and the quickness of this game, how quickly everything changes hands.
Yeah, the turnover game is, that's the way to generate the best offense. If you can get the ball from the other team and you can immediately get it back onto them and trying to get a fast break, that's your best chance at scoring. Once you get into their end and get set up and everybody can get their defensive systems in, teams tend to shut down a little bit. And so especially in a co-ed game, if you get a mismatch of a dominant male against a female, sometimes you get some good scoring chances out of that.
And what a great save right in front by the Maritime goaltender there. There was a lot of generation down there. Number 25 has the ball now. That's Huber Blanchard. And now they're going to try to generate some play behind the net there. But Broomshack's got pretty tight defense there already.
Yeah, this is they play a man-to-man system. And when they get it set up in their own end like that, it's like a blanket coverage. And it really hems them in and makes it extremely difficult to break out. You basically got to take a huge chance to try to get out of the end.
Really battling for it right now. Broomchak currently has the ball. They pass it back out. That's number 89, Alex Perot. Pass back to Perot. Perot's trying to generate something behind the net, looking for an open man.
So this is where the French teams, they like to get a little cycle going out of the corner. They didn't set up for it there because they're getting a line change, but one good system to get some offense when you're set up in the other team's end is to run a cycle from the corner, because if you can get an extra step on someone, being as you don't have skates, you can really, once you get that one step, you can protect the ball and go in and get a shot.
That was a good shot, but just missed wide. That's David Levine again. Levine has the ball. Passes it back out to Emily Parquette. Back to Levine. Levine takes a shot, and that was missed wide.
In my experience playing at the national level, the French teams, they tend to have a lot of skill and a lot of speed. If the Maritime team is going to have a chance today, a lot of it does rest with their goaltender. Watching their game yesterday, she made some incredible saves that really kept her team in it, and then shortly after those saves, they go down and score a big goal.
Melissa Murphy is the goaltender for Maritime there. And down at the other end, Gabrielle Govine, she's down there for Broomshack. But right now, a lot of the offense seems like it's in the Maritime zone, so Broomshack's really going and pressing hard here.
And the Lobster Fishermen, they have a decent game plan for that. Like, they've spent a lot of time in their own end, but they're really not giving up many chances. They seem to be keeping Quebec to the outside. And really, if they have the ball in the corner and behind the net, you're not going to score from there. So although it's not conducive to offense, it's not a bad defense.
Maritime now does have it down at the other end. That's number 93 generating something behind the net. Philippe Bruchard passes out to number 20. That's Marcelin Vatour. He's looking to pass it over to one of his teammates. That's number 66, Rebecca Mosher. And now Broomchak does have it back, flying down the ice. Passes it over, but that pass was missed. Maritime intercepts it again. Now, Ryan, tell me, first of all, how big, and you know, most people don't know the sport of broomball. How big is it, especially in these other provinces like Quebec and the Maritimes?
It is huge in Quebec. The Maritimes, they play, but it's anybody that's been out there knows that going from center to center, there's a lot of traveling, like a lot of hours driven to play. So the Maritimes, it's similar to our leagues around here. Like, it's big in pockets, but it's not big everywhere. A lot of people wouldn't know that broomball is actually on the Canadian Olympic Committee. The CBF executive, you know, they're hopeful that one day it could be an Olympic sport. I don't know if it has that bright of a future because not enough countries do play it, but it is big. It's a strange sport. It's where it's known, it's really big, but there's pockets in between that people don't know what it is at all. So even, for instance, in our local leagues around here, we have a 14-team women's league out of the Acadie and Desborough arenas. But if you go as far as half hour to the east, to Meaford, probably 99% of their population has no idea what it is.
And for, like I said, most of those that don't know, the face-offs, from what I hear, are pretty obsolete, just the regular face-offs that they have here. It's a little bit of a different setup on the rink, isn't it?
Yeah, it's slightly different. The offsides are on the red line instead of at the blue line like in hockey. So essentially there is no neutral zone. The face-offs are in the center of the ice, just because it gets a little bit too congested if you're to do a hockey-style neutral zone face-off. Otherwise, you know, a lot of the rules are very similar to hockey. If someone was to hit the ball above their shoulder with their stick, then that's a penalty instead of just a whistle. That rule is basically just for the safety of the players. There's a lot of players that play without a face mask, and you get people swinging their sticks like a weapon up around the face area. You know, you don't want people losing teeth or breaking noses, especially since it's a recreational sport, and nobody can kid us about that. Everybody that's here, you know, they got to get home on Sunday and they got to go back to work on Monday, and nobody wants to go to work with broken teeth.
Yeah. So right now, midway through the first, it's 0-0 there, and both teams are playing some pretty good defense. We just saw down at the Broomshack zone there, a couple of the defenders making some nice saves in front of the goaltender.
You know, the Maritime, they've come up with a pretty good game plan for this. They were a little bit outclassed by Broomshack in their round robin game. But it seems like they're maybe giving up a little bit of chances on offense to contain them defensively. And if they can keep the game close, and who knows, maybe they'll pop one late and they can come away with a 1-0 or a 2-1 victory.
Nice shot by Maritime, but that just misses wide over the net. Number 14 has it for Maritime. She passes it back. That's over to Junior Duggan. Back to Duggan. It takes a shot, and oh! Good save by the goaltender there. Looks like it deflected off of the stick. Duggan now back, has it back. Takes a shot, and that's missed wide again. It's number 93 for Lou Prouchon. Prouchon has it again, and he'll pass it back to Duggan. Duggan standing there at the top of the point. Back to Prouchon. He takes a shot, and that's missed wide. Duggan looking for a hole.
So for any hockey players that might be watching, typically on a penalty kill in hockey, you play a box. In broomball, it's kind of more conducive to play a diamond. So this way, you put a little bit more pressure on the outside shots. It's kind of an umbrella system on the power play, so you keep three people out around the top so you can get some shots and two people in deep for tips and rebounds. But this diamond, it's a good way of stopping that from getting clear chances.
One miss wide again, and that one goes over the net by Tyron Bro. He takes a shot again, and that's deflected in front of the net. Broomchak now is coming down the other end. That's Jonathan Brunette. He's trying to find another teammate to pass that off to, and he does. The ball is passed out down to the other end. The Maritime has it, they pass it out. Danny Levine has it. He's looking for an opening, he shoots it, and that was missed wide. Oh, good save there by the Maritime goaltender to knock that one away.
Maritimes would be a little disappointed they didn't capitalize on their power play opportunity, but sometimes, in my experience, even just having the power play and getting the ball in the other team's end can turn the tide a little bit. So
let's take a replay of that last save. That was really a nice one, and could almost be a game changer here as Murphy goes and kicks that one aside.
Yeah, as I said yesterday, she was probably the reason that they're here. She played outstanding. And she can keep them in this. You know, they'll have a chance late.
Faceoff is won, and Broomshack gets it. Battling for it hard in the corner there. That's number 25, the assistant captain, Hubert Blanchard. Broomshack moving it up. Now, if you could give me a little bit of a rundown, and those watching back at home, of it. I saw definitely in the neutral zone there. There was even a kick by Broomchak at one point in time. So, in that zone, I'm assuming that they can hit it with their hand or make a hand pass or kick it out into the other zone.
Well, the rules are a little funny that way. Yeah, you can kick it anywhere to anybody, except for you can't kick it into the opposing team's crease. That's an automatic whistle. As far as hand passes go, even though blue lines essentially don't exist in Broomball, if you hand pass behind your blue line, so in your own defensive zone, then that's fine anywhere from the blue line forward, or if you hand pass across the blue line, then that's a whistle and the faceoff goes into your own zone. It's a strange rule that they use the blue line for reference on the hand passes, considering if you had a Broomball only arena, the blue lines wouldn't be there.
Broomchak coming down the other end, looking for an opening to pass it over to number 11. Back over, nice goal there. Broomchak generated a little tic-tac-toe play there. That was fantastic. Gonna take another look at that one shortly.
Yeah, that was a nice goal. That's Quebec people have very good hands on the run. And those are a couple nice passes right on the money.
See, he passes it back over. Number 11 passes it back to him, and Murphy just couldn't get over there in time, but that was a nice goal there.
That's a case of feeling bad for the goaltender. She didn't have much help on that play, that's for sure.
That was Simon Dufresne there. Time makes it all the way back down the other end, and that one was knocked aside by their goaltender. 5 minutes to play through the first, and Maritime currently up 1-0. Broomchak coming down the other end. There's a 2-on-2 here, and that one was just missed as well. Maritime's passing around, trying to dump it out into the opposing zone. That's France Bourgeois there that had it for Maritime, the captain. And now it comes over to Broomchak. Broomchak's right on it, but could not capitalize on that one. Number 24 there behind the net, Colette Labelle. trying to find an opening here. Number four dumps it out. Maritime gets that ball back, but really a nothing play there.
It'll be interesting to see how the team's gas tanks will be a factor here. A lot of hockey players or hockey fans, you know, they'll see that we only play two periods, but when you're not skating and you can't coast, 18 minutes per period, that's plenty of time. Usually in our leagues, most provincials, we play 15-minute periods, and it's amazing what that extra 6 minutes of game time can do.
Yeah.
Really burn your legs out.
Two nice saves there by Broomjack's goaltender, Gabriel Galvin. And you were talking about how there's still so much time left. Broomjack's really got some good offense, and they seem like they're an even team. Defenses, they play as good defense as they do with their offense, generating some movement. And it looks like they've been really ahead of Maritime here in the sense of getting the ball into the other zone.
Yeah, the Quebec teams are always strong. They play the sport, and they start at a young age. A lot of them play it in school and in high school. So they come up with they start playing when they're 6 or 7 or 8 years old. Personally, I didn't start playing broomball until my hockey career was over. You know, it was a choice between trying to play junior C somewhere or play some broomball. And broomball was less of a time commitment and a little bit more social, so... the Quebec teams, they're cut from a different cloth. They play and they play for the sport. And because they play so much, it makes them extremely strong. They've won more national championships than I can even remember. As long as I've started, there's always a Quebec team in each final.
Broomshack now comes down the other end. That's number 17 again, Levine. Levine puts it on the net, and that's a good save by Murphy. Two minutes to go here, and Broomjack up 1-0 on the Maritime Lobster Fisherman.
The stands are a little bit empty right now. Not that I can blame anyone. It is pretty early on a Saturday morning, but we have Polar Ice. Our host team is playing tomorrow, or they're playing at the Rec Center. Heads and Tails are playing at the Rec Center right now, which is another host team. And then our host, Kilsyth Phantoms, are playing at 9:50 this morning. So hopefully we'll see the stands start to fill up before that.
Over the last couple of days here, have you seen a good turnout in fans? Have there been a good amount of fans?
Yeah, there has been a really good amount of fans. It's hard to tell in an arena like this. We really never expected to get 3,000 people here to fill it like we do for the Attack. But, we probably had 500, 600, maybe 700 fans here each night. The one side with the bar, of course, was busier than the side underneath us here, but if we were at a smaller arena, it would have looked really packed. If we had been at the Rec Center, we wouldn't have all fit. So, yeah, we're pretty pleased with the turnout. Obviously, for today's championship games, we're hoping that the local fans get out to check out broomball at its very finest.
Levine has the ball again for Broomshack, looking for an opening. Passes it over to his teammate. Broomjack passing it around the other end and trying to generate something, but they could. Maritime picks it up.
You know, for anyone that wonders about the legitimacy of this game and the games on today, Canada has won basically every world championships that there's been. Every other year, there's a world championship. This year, it's in Regina. As long as I can remember it existing, Canada's had the winning team. Now, there are some very strong American teams that put up a good fight, but really the Canadian teams, whoever wins the gold medal games today, they can probably claim to be the best team in the world, and not a lot of people can doubt that.
Under 30 seconds left to go here in the first period, and Maritime's already down a man here. Going to be a 2-minute power play for Broomshack. Maritime looking on the penalty kill. That's number 10, Simon Dufresne, who's already scored a goal in this game. Dufresne passes it over, and that one's missed wide by number 11, Stefan Malafant. Maritime on the penalty kill, bringing it down the other end, generating a little bit of speed there too, and kicks it all the way down. And that'll do it for the first period here.
Maritimes, they caught a good break there. If you're going to take a penalty, to take it with a period break and somewhere within that penalty kill, that works out well.
And you were talking earlier in the tournament with the fact of Broomshack really handing it to the Maritime. And what do the Lobster Fishermen have to do to be able to get back into this game? And like you said, there's still plenty of time left. We've got a whole other period. But what do they need to do to get past that strong defense that Broomshack has?
I'd say they need to keep playing defense and kind of bank on a turnover. And then when they do that, they need to try to get a mismatch. So if the coach is doing his job, he'll find maybe Broomshack has a weak link, and you'll try to get the man-on-man coverage that you can get your best player against that player. And with a man-on-man coverage the way that a lot of these elite teams play, that's basically your best chance at offense. If you can rotate your offensive players around so you can get the matchup you want, then maybe that player wins a battle one-on-one and gets down and gets a chance. If they keep sitting back in their own end, you know, they might keep the score 1-0, but they also might never have a chance to score a goal. So hopefully they can kill this penalty off and score a goal here somewhere and give us a tight game that's fun for everyone to watch.
And they're just moments away from going back to the first face-off here. If you're just tuning in, we're just getting ready to start the second period of the game one of the semifinals here with Maritime Lobster Fishermen and Broomshack Becancour. And can you let us know, Ryan, how this ranks? Is there any consolation around here, or what happens next? When's the championship game later today?
Essentially, the consolation game is happening right now at the rec center. The Heads or Tails are playing Northwest Territories, and the winner gets fourth, loser is fifth. Same with the girls' division. The semifinal is here after this game, and the girls' consolation game is at the rec center. And then the winner of this will advance to the final. That game starts at 12:30 this afternoon, and then is followed by the girls' gold medal game and then the men's gold medal game.
Maritime dishes it out the other end, but that gets brought back into the zone by the captain there for Broomshack. That's Alex Perot. There's Dufresne again. He passes it over to Perot. Perot takes a shot, and that one's missed wide. Dufresne gets the ball back. Over to Perot again. Melifont takes a shot, and that one was saved by Melissa Murphy, the goaltender for Maritime again.
Well, there's 30 seconds left in this penalty kill. If the fishermen can kill this one off, hopefully they can get something going to get on the offense here. Out of the 18 minutes they've played, they've probably only spent a minute in Broomshack's zone, so hopefully they are just saving their legs for a second half push.
Broomshack trying to generate a play here, getting past this Maritime defense. Maritime gets the ball, turns it over, and comes all the way down the other end. This is number 88. That's Tyron Groh. But the ball comes back the other way, and that's number 17 on Broomshack, Danny Levine again. Maritime brings it all the way to the other end, and that one's intercepted. The shot deflected. That was a good defensive play there to keep the ball from getting near the goalie. Levine passes it over to his teammate.
Yeah, shot blocking is an essential part of defense in Broomball. Because the ball is so much bigger than a hockey puck, it is easy to get a piece of it when somebody's shooting. So that's a very big part of the game, especially on a penalty kill or in your own zone when you might be tired and trying just to kill a shift so you can get off. It's good to square up and try to eat that ball and clear it and get yourself out of the zone.
Broomshack gets the ball. He passed it over to his teammate, and that one was a little bit of a dead play there as the Maritime defender got in the way of that one. Maritime bring it into Broomshack's zone. Broomshack has the ball again. That's number 92 there for them. Oliver Racine. Trying to create something in front, but Maritime steps in front of that one and takes it away. Great defense here from Broomshack. It doesn't seem like they've let up by any means in the first period. Maritime brings it down the other end, looking to start something here. They are down one goal. Got about 14 minutes left in this game. That's number 25. Good save there by Broomshack's goaltender, Galvin.
Thank you. Yeah, say so. I can use some.
Broomshack comes down the other end, bringing it into the Maritime zone. He takes a shot, and that one's missed wide. Melenfant gets it back, and he passes it over to Perreault again. That play's broken up in the middle. Perreault gets the ball back, passes it over. Opening again there to Perreault, but they're gonna switch sides. And that's Dufresne again. Perreault takes a shot, and good save there by Murphy. Nice save there in front again by Murphy, and we've already talked about it. And besides that one goal, which she was left a little bit out to dry there, she's played very well for Maritime and really kept them in this game.
Yeah, the last few games that I've seen them play, she's definitely been their MVP. We'll find out tonight at the awards banquet if she wins the MVP, but she is the biggest reason they're still in this game. Now, if they keep playing this defensive style, they can keep a little bit in the reserve tank for hopefully a late push. I have seen teams in the past that they've played in their own end for 35 out of 36 minutes and then come down at the last and score a goal to win or score a goal to tie and win in overtime. So although they're not generating much offense now, hopefully there's a plan behind it.
More strategy than you think in the sport of broomball.
It is. It's like a chess match. Somebody on the radio was comparing it to soccer, and I never played soccer, but it does make sense. Like you have to have a strategy, and you have to do certain things to try to generate offense because you can't cut and turn the way that you do on skates. So you need design plays or. You need to do something special as an individual to maybe get some offense going.
Maritime passes it over in their zone, dumps it into the other end, and that one was almost taken away again by Danny Levine, but he slipped there. So Broomshack will now get it again behind their net. making a line change here. Broomshack trying to get it down into the Maritime end to make it a two-goal game, but Maritime's playing some quality defense here. You talked about it a little earlier, Ryan, with their strategy here, and they're pressing Broomshack pretty hard right now.
Yeah, they're in their zone, but there we go. They finally got a turnover.
Yeah.
It's hard to score if you'd never have the ball, though.
Yeah. Looks like that. I don't know if that's going to, that's going to be a penalty there for.
Yeah, it was a good back check, but he didn't get any of the ball, so that is a trip, even though it was incidental. That's still a penalty.
Broomshack will go on their second power play of the game here, and they're looking to capitalize. About 11 minutes left in the second period. Face off, and Broomshack wins that one. There's Dufresne again bringing the ball up into the opposing zone. Over to Perreault, back to Dufresne. Perreault takes a shot, and that one's deflected in the air. Good cluster of Lobster Fishermen in front of that net. Dufresne passes it over to a teammate, back to him, over to Perreault again. Dufresne. One's missed wide and almost has a chance to go in the net, but Dufresne takes a shot, and that's a goal! So they score on the power play. That's Dufresne again with his second goal of the game.
Oh, and it's been waved off.
Oh. Let's take a look at that replay there. Perreault passes it over to Dufresne, and he puts it in the back of the net. I'm thinking that they're...
I'm guessing that they're trying to say that Broomshack put a hand on that to deflect it into the net. On that replay, it's hard to see.
Yeah. So that goal was waved off. We'll go back to the replay here. Yeah, there's the handball right there.
Yeah, that's a good call by the ref. She was quite on the ball there. And to be honest, that's the first female ref that I've seen at a Canadian national event, and she is not out of place whatsoever. I believe she is from Northwest Territories, and she's an extremely good representative for them.
That one's missed wide. Broomshack trying to go for round two here with trying to score their second goal. That ball's shot and deflected away. Broomshack has it in the middle. He'll pass it out and take a shot, and that one goes over Murphy's head. It's number 53, Jonathan Lavoie, in there in the mix. Lavoie over to his teammate. That's Levine. Levine tries to pass it out and just misses wide. Murphy's really going toe-to-toe with this Broomshack offense here.
They don't give out Player of the Game awards for the playoff games, but if they did, she would have it hands down no matter what happens in the last 9 minutes.
Lavoie again. Pass over to Lavoie, but that one was knocked away. Broomshack brings it into Maritime's zone. Looking for an opening here. That's over to Levine. Levine takes a shot, and good deflection there by Murphy. Now Maritime has it. That's back for Huber Blanchard, their assistant captain. Blanchard passes it over to his teammate. Marcelin Valu has it, and that one's deflected away. Over to Broomshack again. A lot of speed here from Broomshack, and they bring it into the Maritime zone. We're just under halfway through the second period with about 7:25 left in this game. Maritime coming down the other end. Good pass there over to Valour. Valour takes a shot, and that one's over the head of the Broomshack goaltender. Broomshack looking to get out of their zone, and like we've already talked about, Maritime with good defense there. They do find an opening though, and
yeah, even at times like this though, their Broomshack is on their breakout, and the Maritimes, they're backing over the red line, and if they're going to try to get the ball and get some offense going, they've got to start putting the pressure on. Yeah, they're limiting the Broomshack breakout, but they're not stopping it. They need to get some pressure, maybe force a person into a mistake, get a turnover and a chance from it.
Fuller passes it around, and that one's intercepted by Broomshack in front of the net, but that one was knocked away. It's number 66, Rebecca Mosher, that has the ball right now. Over to her teammate, Jeff Plord. Plord will come around the net. That's back to Levine, or Dufresne, sorry. And that's in the back of the net. That's a goal. That's Chloe Perreault there for a Broomshack Becancour that scored there. And great goal by Broomshack to go up 2-0 late in this game. See it here.
No, that was a good shot. She shouldn't have probably been so open out in the slot, but at this stage of the game, with just under 6 minutes left and a 2-0 lead, the way that this game has been going, that probably seems pretty safe, I would think. Hopefully the Fishermen can get a couple chances here and get this game close to even again.
Broomshack once again back in the Maritime zone. They've really kept it in the Maritime zone all game, but Maritime tries to pass it out here, and you look at the shot ratio, and we don't have the exact numbers, but it looks really lopsided here for Broomshack with shots on net.
You could almost say lobster sided.
Yeah.
I don't know, the Maritime team, the anybody that knows Maritime people, they're typically pretty social, so looks like maybe they might have went and caught some of our festivities last night. Potentially at maybe Jason's pub or the Harb.
Maritime really trying to create something in Broomshack's zone, but Broomshack just being too fast, bringing it all the way down the other end. And, just misses. That was a nice play there.
That move, there's two names for it. Some people call it the Spaceman. Some people call it the Superman. But if a person is good on it, this move, that hand-to-stick pass to yourself, it is virtually unstoppable. There is a player that he's in the Hall of Fame now that used to play for Ember and Plumbing in the 90s, that he could do that, and he could do it between his legs, he could spin and do it, and he could basically at will score anytime he wanted with that. It is virtually unstoppable, and that guy just narrowly missed the net there, but if somebody gets a breakaway and pulls that move, a goaltender's got no chance.
Maritime bringing it across to their other into Broom Shack's zone, but back into the Maritime zone goes Broom Shack. Broom Shack looking for another goal, but Maritime's playing some strong D, being down by two. Maritime, there on the other end, takes a shot on net, and that one's deflected away by Gabriel Galvin, the goaltender for Broom Shack. And she hasn't had much action today, but when she has, she's certainly come up with those saves. She's about 3 minutes and 40 seconds away from a shutout, moving them on.
Oh, you said the S word. You probably just jinxed her. That's as in hockey too, but with Broomball, your goaltender is your most important player. There's definitely, I've been in a lot of games where our goaltenders have stole a game for us. Our first men's nationals in 2010 in Arnprior, Robin Mole won the championship game MVP, even though we lost, just because he made, you know, five alarm saves.
And that was a great save there by Galvin.
And it's probably twice as important in co-ed because typically it's a female goaltender. And some of those guys, they get wiring shots at them. It's, you know, it's coming at you. And for them to be able to stand in there and keep composure and make those saves, it's, if you got a good goalie, you become a favorite just like that.
Here's Levine, oh, with a nifty shot, and it doesn't go in the first time, but he scores there with the scoring on his knees. That's 3-0 now for Broomshack.
Yeah, I would say that would be the final nail in the coffin. Probably the next 2:28 is a bit of a formality. But you got to give the Fishermen credit. They haven't been here for years, and they put up a good fight.
And that one just tough for any goaltender, really, to save that one. That was a nice goal there by Levine.
Yeah, she did all she could on that one. She didn't have a... Same thing, not much for a back check. She didn't have a whole lot of help, but if I were to be picking a player of the game, she'd still get it because she may have given up three goals, but that's on 30-some shots. So
yeah.
She's definitely been the best player on the ice.
A little over 2 minutes left to go in this game, and if you're just tuning in, Broomshack Becancour up 3-0 over the Maritime Lobster Fishermen. So it looks like Broomshack could go on here, but you never know of in Broomball as anything could go. But
especially with the Maritimes off to the penalty kill here, with even if they kill it off, that would leave them with 9 seconds to score three goals, and I've never seen that, and I don't think I ever will.
Yeah. So here's a face-off. That's to the left of Murphy, the goaltender. Broomshack wins it.
And it is setting up for a good gold medal game. If Broomshack and Ontario misled, that'll be their third matchup of the week. They played in the round robin and misled one. And then yesterday in the Page playoff, misled was down 2-0 and came back. They took a timeout in the first period, kind of got their composure and came back and won the game 3-2. So it'll be interesting to see how that final goes. There's a lot of familiarity there now.
Good save there by Murphy. So if Broomshack does come away with it, which it looks like they most certainly could, it will be Broomshack, Becancour, and Misled in the championship game.
Yep, Ontario Misled. They're from the Ottawa region. They won last year's provincial championships to qualify for this tournament, and they've picked up a couple supporting players to round out their roster, and they've been very strong this week.
Well, it looks like just from what I've seen in the standings, I shouldn't say they look unstoppable, but they look very tough to try to beat.
Yeah, it'll be an even game. The game yesterday in the Page playoff was back and forth, and it was pretty entertaining.
Becancour here, that was Simon Dufresne who scored the first goal of the game for Broomshack. And they're just going to let time run out here as they're up by three with less than a minute to go.
Yeah, it's kind of good. I've seen teams in the past that they'd still be trying, pressing really hard to put a fourth goal in. It's kind of unnecessary. Broomball is very much a social sport, and trying to, you don't want to disrespect your opponents because we're all there for the same reasons. So it's good to see a Quebec team that, you know, they're not trying to score. They're just killing the clock.
Broom Shack trying to... It doesn't look like they'll be putting in a fourth goal, but definitely coming away with this one. They do generate something out in front, but Murphy's there to save it, and that one goes over the net.
There.
Great chance. And there you have it. That's going to be the end of this game. Broomshack, Becancour, they come away with a 3-0 win over the Maritime Lobster Fishermen. And they'll move on to the final game. Great game overall defensively. It was a very defensively sound game. Melissa Murphy for the Lobster Fisherman. We've already talked about her a number of times, but she played really well for the Lobster. And the other, you got to hand it to Gabrielle Gauvin, the goaltender down for Becancour, where she didn't see many shots, but when there was, she definitely made it count with a 3-0 shutout.
Yeah, that's a tough job for those goalies on good teams. You know, you could sit there for 10-15 minutes and basically do nothing but watch, and then a team comes down and gets a chance, and you got to be on your toes. That's I don't envy goalies in any aspect. You know, I wouldn't want to play that sport, or I wouldn't want to play that position, even probably if you paid me. So to sit there and for 10 minutes and then come down and have a guy or a girl try to put one by you, be able to come up with a big stop, that's a very difficult task.
And there you have it, 3-0 Broom Shack over the Lobster Fishermen. And we do have to give some credit to Maritime here, as you did say earlier, that this being the very first time that they've made it this far in. So
you got to give them a special credit, because it's two provinces that are put together for this event. So they don't play together all year. They had to come here and basically almost meet each other and then mesh together to play. So for them to come away with a bronze medal, it's disappointing right now, I'm sure, for them. But when they look back and, you know, they finished third in the country, they're not going to be ashamed by any means. And the silver lining is, now that they're done for the day, once the bar opens, they can be right there.
Yeah, and the one thing I love is the Maritime Lobster Fisherman. Isn't that a really cool name there?
It is. It is. We didn't know their team name until about 6 weeks ago, and they sent us their logo and their uniform, a picture of their uniforms. And, you know, that really, for me, and I know it's stereotypical, but that sums up the Maritimes for me. So
yeah, yeah.
The only thing that might have been better would be a bottle of Screech in the Lobster's claw.
Who do you think was, if we had to bring somebody, a player of the game in for both teams, if you could pick one, who would you say?
Oh, I'd definitely pick Megan Murphy for the Lobster Fisherman. She played outstanding, and with the way that the Lobster Fishermen played in their own end for most of the game, she was by far their best player. And then the gentleman that scored the first goal for Broom Shack, he seemed to control the play on the power plays and just in their breakout and in their own end. He seemed to have the pulse of the team, and everything kind of went through him. So,
and if I had to pick, I'd pick the same two. Melissa Murphy faced a lot of shots today, but she was definitely the one that kept them in not only this tournament, not only this game, but the entire tournament. And Simon Dufresne, they're the assistant captain for Broomshack. So there you have it, a 3-0 win for Broomshack Becancour over Maritime Lobster Fishermen. They will go on to the gold medal game today. I'm Matt Sanderson here with Ryan Gregg, and we're going to go to a break and come back for the next championship.
Yeah, the next game is the defending champion Quebec Huskies against the Eastern Rebels. It's actually a rematch of last year's championship game at the Nationals. which hopefully it doesn't go as long as that. Last year they played to a nothing-nothing tie and then played almost two full periods of overtime. So essentially they played two complete games before the Huskies scored to end it. So hopefully they can get it done in regulation, because we have a pretty tight schedule and we don't want to be too far behind today.
So we'll step away for a little bit and be right back here at the Harry Lumley Bayshore Community Center in Owen Sound.